Give it to me. Just do it. Come on.
Okay.
I'm not gonna let you sell this to the highest bidder. This time we're gonna do it the right way.
Yeah, you keep telling yourself that.
Step away from the hard drive. Now! Sorry, Frank. Bye.
So, what? No more mini golf? Hammond needed me. Her tyrant had turned into a psychopath. So we took him down, and Hammond made sure he wouldn't be getting up again. In exchange, Hammond gave me the most important gift of all, friendship. And more importantly, a big bomb to blast my way into Calder's lair. The sewers. Calder and his posse of creepy, smart zombies had turned them into some kind of den of spooky-ass shit. And Calder himself can talk. Whatever he's become, there's still a little bit of psycho douchebag human still in there. Naturally, I grabbed the intel and booked it. And that would have been where our story ended. Frank West, triumphant hero of Willamette, once again. Vic Chu. Thief. Hellspawn. She stole my evidence. She held a gun to my head, and now it's on.
Happening.
Vic stole my camera! She has the evidence!
What? Then get it back!
Great advice, Brad! This isn't over yet, rookie!
Screw you, Frank! Yeah!
Goddamn camera! a big problem. I mean, another big problem.
Oh, really?
Through Caribbean Cove.
Hang on a minute. Head upstairs. You can cut her off at Kichiro Plaza.
Kichiro Plaza. That evidence is mine. Oh, Vic! Calder's not fucking around! Shit you're doing, Vic! Vic!
Fatality. Huh? That's right.
Remember me? I just hope we can talk about this.
You hide behind glass! Take all you see. Claim this, take that. Make it all yours. Give nothing back.
All right. A bit heavy, but I agree. I could do better. Tomorrow morning. Give me the camera back. I'm a new man tomorrow, I promise.
You are part of the chain, Frank West. And I must break the chain.
No. You did it. God, I hate you. Okay. You know what? You hurt my student. Took my story. And now you've blown up my favorite camera.
So be it. Frank West was the zombie lord. Let's roll, weirdo.
Let's roll.
All right, Vic! Vic! Where the hell are you going? You left me! Again!
I've got a plan. Thank you.
me?
Yeah.
She left me! Again!
Frank, you hear me?
Rick, where are you?
Control room. How you doing down there? You all right?
Your concern is very touching.
Head to the spa. I've opened the gate for you.
Yeah, I don't think a pedicure is gonna help.
Less fast, please.
Yeah? You first! Yes! Nice work, kiddo!
We're ending this, Frank.
Damn straight!
She said.
Yeah, thought you'd like that. I've opened more shops for you, Frank.
Why didn't we team up earlier?
Because you're an egomaniac.
Yeah? Well, you're a dangerous vigilante!
They
zombie, son of a bitch!
Time to ring in the new year!
I need you at Kichiro Plaza. I need medical assistance now. Okay, come on. Stay with me, kid. Stay with me.
Presents for hands.
But we lost everything. Camera, Barnaby's servers were wiped, and you blew the hard drive to a million pieces, so... Hey, you weren't really gonna shoot me, right?
No, we're fatal.
Like the leg?
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Fair enough. I deserve that. But listen, if it comes up again, can you aim for the right one? It's kind of a piece of shit anyway.
Frank. I'm really sorry about that.
Don't worry about it. I've had worse. And so will you. That's kind of the shit you go through when you're a good journalist, right?
What about being a great journalist?
What is that?
An SD card? From your camera?
You pulled it?
Yeah.
Before it blew up?
Go on.
What do you want for it?
Oh, jeez.
No, I mean it. I'll give you anything.
All right. I want the story. My words, your pictures. Big coverage, big impact.
Together, 50-50.
Yeah, 50-50.
I like the sounds of that. Plus mini golf.
Oh man, not the mini golf. Yeah, okay. Mini golf.
Wait, what am I doing with a chair in my hand?
We sorted everything out. We need to get to the rendezvous point if we want to lift out of here.
You don't have to tell me twice.
Grab anything you need, and let me know when you're ready to go.
I don't want this chair. Well, I'll take the toast. WJE.
I admit, your knowledge of the outbreak is impressive.
Thanks, I'm really enthusiastic about outbreak tourism.
I can see that. We'd hope that the zombie tours would run several times a day.
me, Mr. Handy.
That should be doable. I've walked through a couple of prototype tours in my head, and I think you could do the whole circuit in an hour and a half on foot.
Foot
tours? No, absolutely not. Let me educate you. Tourists are terrible walkers. We're putting them in a bus, a tour bus. We can fit four people.
Oh, sure. That can work too, and it can end at the museum.
Yes! Brilliant!
I'll get this gate open.
We don't have a museum. How about the gift shop?
So, did your heart grow three sizes this Christmas, Frank?
Come on. We're good now, right? We're good?
Let's publish this story. Save the world. Then we'll be good.
You need to get out of Willamette first. Let's go.
Think the government will start destroying our lives?
Sing!
Well, they don't sound very happy.
Think they're mad at us, Daddy?
We're meeting the helicopter on the roof of the parking garage, just over the sky bridge.
Oh, good! Nice and convenient!
They're mad because we killed their daddy.
Did everyone get a souvenir? Yeah.
PTSD counts, right?
It did for me.
I think we pissed them off.
Come on!
Give me a second with this door.
No! We don't have a second!
We don't have a second? You're not mad and we don't have a second.
Please tell me that's alright! I need a pocket with you!
Thank you.
up, up! Hustle, hustle!
Oh no, Brad, we'll be cornered!
We got supplies! We can make a stand here!
So the next chopper can get zombie bombed?
My people won't let us down. We're getting out of here. Just
drum.
If Frank could have it his way, this is where the story would end. He'd die a hero, sacrificing himself for the good of his friends. You wouldn't need to follow it up to see the mess that unfolded in the months after. But Frank's not here to tell the story his way. He can't load it up with spicy embellishments. Listening to his notes, I kind of wonder how the story would have gone when he told it later. Would he have defeated Fontana in single combat? Refused to conspire with the evil Dr. Blackburn? Added a sweet romance to the city engineer? I'm sure his second book would have sold as well as his first. But Frank's not here to tell his story. So he's gotta trust me to do it. Whether he wanted it that way or not. And I say, the truth is better than fiction.